The second type of verses, the verses that have within them the predictions of what is going to happen in the future. So you have, for example, the day of judgment, the description of the end of times, what will happen, some of the signs, etc. These prophecies, everything mentioned in the Quran, these are a large number of verses in the Quran, and we as mu'mineen and believers believe firmly that this is the absolute truth. It will definitely happen. The third type of verses, which is extremely important, verses that have what is known as حُكْمُ مَا بَيْنَنَا. They have rules and regulations regarding our living, that which happens between us, that which happens in our lives. Now, in order to fulfill these rules and regulations, we need to understand them. When Allah speaks about salah, salah is prayer. You cannot choose to do what you want and substantiate it by saying Allah says wa aqimus salata wa atu zakata. So I'm going to give one shoe away, for example, to the man who lives down the road, and I'm going to, for example, perhaps hop on my feet for 10 minutes and then that's my prayer. You cannot do that. There is a method. There is an understanding. There are conditions for salah. You need to have wudu. You need to learn about it from the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the verses are all applicable. It's not like it's not applicable, but the method of application is where we need to understand. We go back to the sunnah. We understand the context of revelation. We look at what happened and we look at how to apply the rules and regulations. What is farad? Compulsory. What is sunnah? What is nafil? This is explained elsewhere, not necessarily in the Quran, subhanallah. How many salah they are, where they are meant to be fulfilled, how they are meant to be fulfilled, where are you facing the conditions, the rules and the regulations. The same applies to zakah.